Hello everyone, good morning and welcome to International Women's Day 2022. My name is Alice Eikenboom. I'm a PhD candidate in the departments of clinical genetics and gastroenterology, and I'm also a board member of the Female Academic Association of the Erasmus Medical Center called FENA. And I have the honor today to moderate this event because this year is the first time that we celebrate this day in the Erasmus Medical Center. And for this purpose, the Task Force Diversity and Inclusion joined forces with FENA to host this event. And in light of the recent events, inequality is still a very important topic to reflect on, because it is our mission to make sure that everyone feels safe and welcome in the Erasmus MC. And additionally, we want to make sure that there are equal opportunities for everyone. And despite being called International Women's Day, we made sure that the program is applicable to everyone. So not only women, but people from every gender and also from minority groups. This day was set up to reflect on barriers that people encounter in academia and eventually to search for possible solutions. For this purpose, we also value your opinion, so stay tuned. To kick off International Women's Day 2022, I want to give the floor to Dr. Joke Boonstra and Professor Dr. Arfan Ikram. As executive board member of the Erasmus MC and as chair of the Task Force Diversity and Inclusion, they both have affinity with this topic. They will elaborate on their views and experiences with inequality. So Joke and Arfan, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much for this warm welcome and welcome to everybody for looking today at this day. Many thanks to FENA and to the task force, Arfan, for organizing this important day. For me, it's a day about positivity and a day to celebrate. I think in a time where we have this war in Europe, this terrible war, I think we feel privileged that we have the time and freedom to discuss matters that are so important to us. It's also a time to celebrate, I think, diversity in Erasmus MC, because every day when I walk and work here, we see the diversity of the people who work here, the chances that everybody gets here, and the diversity of thoughts. So I think Erasmus MC is an inclusive organization, and many people have challenges and opportunities here. And I think it's good to celebrate that. I think we can also be positive about the chances we have then as women here in society. If you look now to The Hague, for instance, half of the ministries is led by women. So, you know, if you compare that to the previous generation, and I often mention my mother, you know, she worked as a nurse in the 70s, and she was fired because she got married. You know, and if you see what has already happened in one generation, I think it's we can be positive about the changes that have happened in society. So for me, it's a day about positivity and let's celebrate what we have and how rich we are to be able to discuss in freedom these important subjects. Arfan, how do you think about that?
Yes, I fully agree with you, Joke. So first of all, good morning to everyone as well, also to the viewers. It's fantastic for me to be here, great honor. And if you talk about International Women's Day, I think it's a great occasion to celebrate what you just mentioned, Joke, really to celebrate the achievements by women and the women's talent that is present, not only in Erasmus MC, but in society at large. And today we're really going to talk about those achievements, those talents, those opportunities, but also about challenges. Now, I'm standing here as the chairman of the Task Force Diversity and Inclusivity, and I think it's fantastic that we can partner with FENA to organize this day. At the same time, I've very often said, as chairman, people ask me like, hey, what do you think the task force should do? And my answer is always the same. The ultimate goal of this task force is that we make ourselves redundant, because diversity and inclusivity should become part of our DNA. It should be such a open, transparent topic that you do not need a task force to ensure that this topic is on the agenda. Now, I also want to briefly talk a bit about what I hope that the viewers and people here today will learn from all the various sessions. And I want to do that with the example of role models. Now, obviously, if you talk about International Women's Day, the first thing I think most people think of are female role models. And we have one excellent example standing here next to me, Joke, and others here present. But we need to realize that the audience for International Women's Day, it's not only women. it's also the other half of the world population, the men. Now, if you then talk about role models, obviously, I can imagine that most women may or can identify with some of the female role models that will be present here today. But what are the role models for men? Whom do they identify with? Yeah. And I think for me, it's fantastic that today in the various panels, we also have male role models that, in my opinion, really embrace the topic of inclusivity and diversity. And I'm very much looking forward to hearing from them how they went through this process and, again, embraced this topic of diversity and inclusivity.
Absolutely. Because, Arvan, I think you also often get the questions, like I do, like I get, how did you get where you are right now in your career? What did it take to get here?
That's a seemingly easy question, but it's very difficult to answer. And the first thought that comes to my mind is that I never planned for these things. So if we reverse the time, let's say 10, 15 years, and you would ask me, like, Arvan, can you give give me 10 scenarios of how you think your career will move forward? None of those 10 scenarios would have the actual career path that I had. So for me, planning too far ahead and in too much detail doesn't make sense. I think ultimately for me, it's been the ambition to really grow, not only academically, professionally, but also personally, to really seek the challenge. And very briefly, Joke, an example I give to my PhD students very often, and also to other junior staff members that are working exceedingly hard to reach the next level, and I ask them, like, what do you think will happen in the next level? And they're like, yeah, if I have this or that, it will become easier, or I won't have much stress that I am experiencing now. And I always say, well, you should aspire for the next level, not with the hope that it becomes easier, because it won't. So don't have that expectation. You should aspire to the next level because you feel you're ready for the next set of challenges.
Yes.
And if you have that motivation, I think that's, and then just let things happen and your career will move itself forward. Yeah. But I'd like to hear your thoughts, Joke, about your experiences.
I absolutely agree, Arvan. It is, you have to be ready for the next challenges. You have to like that. You have to like difficulties and to overcome them. And I think it's also about knowing yourself, you know, what you're good at, but also what you're not good at.
Oh, yes. Exactly.
You know, I would have been a terrible professor, you know, and my PhD, it was okay, you know, it was nice, but I realized quite early that, you know, being a real scientist was not for me. So I choose a different path. And that is, you know, knowing yourself, knowing what you're good at, what you're not good at, but then also the will to grow and to develop and learn. I'm 50, I'm nearly 51, but still have, you know, the urge to learn more.
Exactly.
And to become better at what you are. But knowing yourself and realizing that you can't be good at everything.
Exactly,
I think it's important. And then sometimes it also, you know, I didn't plan my career just like you, but it's sometimes, you know, things choose you. You don't choose yourself,
but choose you.
And then you can, you know, try to accept that. Choose what chooses you.
Exactly.
I think that's an important one.
I think you mentioned a very important point here, where you said that you don't only know, not only know what you're good at, but what you're not so good at. And I think many people find that confrontational to realize that they may not be excellent at everything, that it may be a limitation. And I think it's good that you realize that, because once you have that realization, you know which aspects perhaps to develop or which aspects you can actually excel in.
Yep.
And that will also ensure that some things not going your way won't be seen and won't be experienced by you as a failure, because it's not.
No.
It's, as you
it's
say,
an opportunity to
exactly. Things choose you. So realize that that for every lost opportunity, there may be two or three other opportunities.
Yep.
It's really a matter of recognizing those and then grasping those.
Interesting. Okay. I think this is a nice start, Arvan.
Yes.
For the day.
Fantastic.
Yes. So have a very nice day. Enjoy it. Enjoy the lectures. And we hope to see you again.
Thank you very much, Joke and Arvan, for the valuable insights into your experiences. And I think it's really supportive to also hear from two leading people in the Erasmus MC to hear what your experiences are. So thank you very much. Yeah. And I think that's really inspiring, because discussing these kind of things, it also raises awareness, and that makes sure that change can be set in motion. So thank you very much. So for our next part of the program, we have, until we proceed to the next part of our program, we have a small break of approximately 20 minutes. At 10 o'clock, we will proceed with a panel discussion led by Dr. Interviewer Esther Warnert. And oh, I see Esther is already here. Hi. Okay, great. I would like to invite Esther Warnert here. Well, you can be over there, that's okay. Esther is my fellow board member at VENA, and she will be hosting the panel discussion, which is about chances, challenges and possible solutions in gender equality for a sustainable tomorrow. And Esther, will you please introduce yourself?
Ja, dat vertelde je gisteren, ja. Daar kan je opnieuw op antwoorden. Dat doet er ook niet toe.
Good morning, everyone, and again, very welcome. Again, a nice thank you to Jörg and Arfan for that nice introduction. And of course, Alice, who is, you don't really see all of her, but she's radiating, looks really good.
We are preparing here in the background for the next session. So I think we start at 10 a.m. and we have two panel discussions for you ready, talking about how to reach a sustainable tomorrow, and of course doing that via reaching gender equality and inclusivity and diversity. And I think without further ado, this is the time for the break.
So please grab yourself a nice cup of coffee and prepare yourself for the panel discussion.
Yep.
We will proceed at 10 o'clock. So see you then. Thank you.
See you at 10.